टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आरआरबी फिजिक्स सब्जेक्ट। वी हैव द वन कॉमन डाउट, व्हाट इज द लेवल ऑफ क्वेश्चन इन आरआरबी। सी द लेवल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इन रेलवे रिक्रूटमेंट बोर्ड आर अप टू 10th standard levels only. From 6th to 10th standard it is. In generally, aspirants are having some doubt. Maybe the level of questions up to degree or inter level. It is not correct. In the syllabus, recruitment board very clearly mentioned, that is, it is GS or general awareness. Syllabus is general awareness. General means it is daily life related. It's very common. Awareness is understanding. Having the awareness in our environment. So general awareness. In this general awareness, so many topics are there. They are, one is general science and another topic is social studies. General science, social studies. In this general science, there are four topics are there. We know one is botany, zoology, physics, chemistry. Botany and zoology, these are called as biological sciences. Biological sciences. Physics, chemistry, these two subjects called as physical sciences. Up to 10th standard, these are called physical sciences and biological sciences. So we have the only one book for this general science, entire general science in NCERT textbook. Social studies, we know it is also contains four topics. They are geography, history, economy and polity. We know. What is the reference book for this four topics? Yes, here also we have only one book, that is NCERT textbook up to 10th standard. And also in this area, general awareness contest, GK means very basic information and current affairs related to present situations. Up to 6 months, before 6 months of the examination. So better to refer up to October, because of if we have the examination in December, better to refer the books or test papers or newspapers up to November is enough. Just before 15 days, up to 6 months, before 6 months of the examination, we have to refer the magazines, or weekly magazines, or monthly magazines, or daily newspaper. Yes, this is the syllabus. Reference books is NCERT textbooks are the reference books. So our subject, now we are going to discuss about this physics subject, how to prepare this subject. For this, physics subject, it is the one of the most important subject in our railway recruitment board examination. How to prepare this subject? First of all, we have to remember what is the context or syllabus of the subject. Syllabus, basic knowledge or basic information. Basic knowledge in the subject, very basic knowledge. What is what? Second one is understanding the subject. Understanding. Then third one, applications. Applications of the subject with respect to topic. Topic wise applications in our daily life. 70 to 80% of questions asking daily life related questions asking in the examination point of view. And also, especially in our railway recruitment board, examinations like JEE, NTPC, Group D, whatever it is, in these kind of examinations, examiners sometimes also frame the questions on numericals. Numericals related questions also asking. You have to remember this one. Except this RRB, remaining competitive examinations, either state level examinations or central level examinations, yes, we have to just focus these three topics enough. Means basic knowledge, understanding of the subject, applications regarding to that topics in this subject. But here, numerical questions also asking. These numericals also very, very basic related questions asking. Basic related questions asking, like formula related questions, like calculate the kinetic energy or calculate the potential energy, calculate the work, calculate the torque, like this. These kind of questions are appearing in the examination. So what is the syllabus for this physics subject? Now, see, physics syllabus for railways. First one, mechanics. Mechanics chapter, it consists a kinematics and dynamics. What is the difference in between these two topics, kinematics and dynamics? Kinematics, it is only explains the kinematical equations of an object without external force on an object. But dynamics, it explains about the motion of an object including of the external forces on an object. You have to remember, just only it explains about the kinematical equations only. But this one, including of external forces, motion of an object explain. It contains two topics. They are, one is force and loss of motion, then second topic is work, power and energy. Second chapter, measurements and units. Third topic, sound. Fourth one, heat, or simply called as heat energy, because of these are the forms of energies. Sound energy, heat energy. Sixth chapter, liquids. Fifth chapter, liquids. Sixth one, our universe. Seventh one, modern physics. Eighth one, electricity or electric energy. Ninth one, magnetism. 10th chapter, electromagnetic spectrum. And 11th one is light. See, here, how many chapters are there? 11 topics are there. Out of these 11, our first doubt is which are the most important topics regarding our RRB examination. See, this is the competitive examination, not academic examination. In academic examinations, we have the some chances are there. For example, there are four units. among these four units, just if we prepare the two units perfectly, then we can pass. But in competitive examinations, we can't justify this kind of choices. So that is why every topic is important. Every topic is most important. So however, among these 11 chapters, as per previous competitive examinations, first one, mechanics is the one of the most important topic. And also expecting from sound. Fourth one is heat. Electricity. 11th one is light. See, once again, all the topics are most important in competitive examination point of view. But as for the previous examinations, examiner focusing on these topics like light, electricity, and heat, sound, and mechanics. Yes, these are the expecting areas. Also asking the questions, numerical related questions also asking, you have to remember this one. Now, today we are going to discuss about mechanics chapter. Mechanics. Mechanics. Here there are two topics are there. One is kinematics. Second chapter, dynamics. Kinematics already discussed. Kinematics in this chapter, we have to discuss only about the kinematical equations. We will discuss later about this concept. But dynamics, it is the one of the most important topic. Dynamics, it explains the motion of an object including of the external forces. Important one. Which of the following branch of mechanics explain the motion of an object including of the forces? Option A, kinematics. Option B, dynamics. Option C, A and B. Option D, none of the above. Which one explains? Dynamics. It explains about the motion of an object including of the external forces. But it is just only explain the kinematical equations. In this dynamics, first one is force and laws of motion. Force and laws of motion. In our daily life, we are very oftenly using this word force, which is called as force. It is also previous examination question. Force is defined as option A, product of mass and velocity. Option B, mass and acceleration. Option C, work by time. Option D, none of the above. This type of questions also framing. This is the previous examination. What is that question? Force is defined as option A, product of mass and velocity. Option B, product of mass and acceleration. Option C, work done by time period. Option D, none of the above. Yes. In this, which one is the correct one? First of all, we try to discuss about this one. See, first of all, force. See, why should we have to use this sign, arrow mark? It indicates force is a vector quantity. It is a vector quantity, which is called as vector quantity. Yes, the physical quantity, force is a one physical quantity. The physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction. See, for example, it is an object. Mass of this object is 5 kg. Mass of the object 5 kg. Where it is located? At A. 5 kg mass of an object is placed at A. We want to change the position of this object from A to B. How it change from A to B? How it is possible? Yes, some physical quantity is required. Especially which one is required here? Some external, what is that? Force, that is the physical quantity. So we have to apply the force. When it is moves from A to B, if we apply the force on this object from left to right, if we apply the force on this object from right to left, what happens? It away from the A. Our concept is that object must be moves from A to B. That is why it must be moves from A to B, means here left to right. Here it indicates, what is that? Direction. That is why it is called, what we call, vector quantity. Some physical quantities are having the direction. They depends on the direction. That is why these kind of quantities are called vector quantities. One more thing. Here, 5 kg is the mass. Mass of an object. It is the magnitude. 5 kg is the magnitude. So the physical quantity, it must be contains one is magnitude and as well as direction. 5 kg mass of this object moves from A to B. Here, how much force is required to move? See, 3 newtons force is required to move from A to B. It is the magnitude. It is the direction. If we apply the 3 newtons force from left to right, then it will reaches the B. It contains magnitude and direction. That is why it is called, what we call, force. Simply, examiner will be asking. Force is A dash. Option A, scalar quantity. Option B, vector quantity. Option C, pseudo physical quantity. Option D, none of the above. Pseudo means chances are there, maybe either scalar quantity or vector quantity. So however, it is a vector quantity, it's not a scalar quantity, because of it contains these two concepts, right? So one more thing. Here, it is an object. Mass of the object, M. See, it moves from A to B. One object is moving from one point to another point, it must be contains the some speed. Without speed, it is impossible to move. So the change in the speed of an object is called as acceleration, rate of change of velocity. Why? Because here object changes from one point to another point with respect to time period. Speed varies. Let us see. For example, if we are at home, we are at home or institution, home or hostel, let us suppose. We want to reach the institution. In between these two positions, speed of an object will be varies, not never constant. That is why the change in the speed with respect to time period, that is called what we call acceleration. However, the product of mass and acceleration is called as what we call force. For this, yes, see, which is called force? The product of mass and acceleration is called what we call force. That is why among these four options, which one is correct one here? Yes, here, this one is the correct one. Product of mass and acceleration is the correct one in this. Classification of forces. Classification of forces. See, forces are mainly classified into two types. They are, one is balanced forces means two forces are equal. For example, it is force A, this is the force B. If two forces are equal, so resultant force of these two forces of A and B equal to zero. When the effective or resultant force of the two forces is zero, that kind of forces are called what we call balanced forces. Unbalanced forces in the universe, forces are generally, most of the forces are unbalanced forces. It is the, we have to see, it is the one ideal concept. It's always correct. It's not always correct. So then second one is unbalanced forces. It is the important one. Unbalanced forces. If it is balanced, need not to study about them. When it is unbalanced, we have to discuss about them. In this unbalancing forces, unbalanced forces are once again classified or categorized into two types. They are, one is contact forces. Then second one is non-contact forces. If contact means both surfaces of the two objects must be touch with them. Without touch, however, some forces acting in between the two objects, that kind of forces are called non-contact forces. Also, these forces are also called as field forces. Non-contact forces, these are also called as field forces. See, contact forces, when the two surfaces are contact with each other, in that situation some forces acting. In this, contact forces are classified into four types. Number one, normal force. Second one is tension force. Third one, muscular force. Then fourth one is friction force, simply called as friction or frictional force. These are the contact forces. Normal force, second one tension force, third one muscular force, fourth one frictional force or friction force. In non-contact or field forces, in this, First one is gravitational force. Gravitational force. Then second one is electrostatic force. Electrostatic force. Electrostatic force. Then third one is magnetic force. Gravitational force, electrostatic force, third one is magnetic force. See the classification of force. Forces are mainly classified into two types. They are balanced forces, unbalanced forces. It is not an important question. Forces are mainly classified into, don't like this, but unbalanced forces are how many types? Here two types. What are they? Contact and non-contact or field forces. How to frame the question from this area? Which of the following is a field force? See question once again. Which of the following force is a non-contact force or field force? Option A, gravitational force. Which of the following is a field force? Option A, gravitational force. Option B, normal force. Option C, tension force or tension. Then fourth one is muscular force. We know very clearly here, gravitational force is the field force or non-contact force. But except gravitational force, remaining all the forces are contact forces. This is the direct question. Awareness, just if we have the awareness on this classification, easily we can identify. The next one is just vary. The question will be varies. Framing is different. What is that? Which of the following is not a contact, non-contact force? Which of the following force is not a non-contact force or field force? Option A, gravitational force. Option B, muscular force. Option C, electrostatic force. Option D, magnetic force. We know very clearly, these are all field forces, but this one is the contact force. So if we having the classification, then easily we can identify. This is also one of the important area. See, normal force, which is called normal force. Normal force. See, it is a one table. A book on the table. Book. Yes. Weight of this book acting downwards. Weight of the book acting downwards. So that is denoted by W, we know. At the same time, when book weight is acting downwards, when it is acting downwards, some force acting on the book in vertically upwards. The force which is acting on an object, or the force which is acting on the book in vertically upward direction. The force which is acting on an object which is on the surface of the table, that force is called what we call normal force. Weight of the body in generally acting downwards. When it is acting downwards on this object, some forces will be acting upward direction for balancing. The force which is acting on this object in vertically upward, that force is called what we call normal force. See, for example, if weight of the object is more than the normal force, weight is more than the upward forces or normal force, what happens? Then object will be felt. It will be fall down, isn't it? So that is why, when it is possible, weight of the body must be either less than or equal to normal force, it is in equilibrium position or in rest position. Then tension force, very simple. See, it's a wire, we know. इट्स ए वायर. द मास ऑफ दिस वायर इज लेस देन द डिवाइस. हाउएवर वी कैन इजिली सस्पेंडेड दिस ऑब्जेक्ट बाय हेल्प ऑफ दिस रोप और वायर. द फोर्स इन द वायर इज कॉल्ड व्हाट वी कॉल टेंशन. फोर्स इन द वायर आर थ्रेड दट इज कॉल्ड व्हाट वी कॉल टेंशन फोर्स. इट इज हेल्पफुल टू हैंग द सब्सटेंसेस. देन थर्ड वन मस्क्युलर फोर्स. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट द सम इंफॉर्मेशन और टेस्ट ऑन दिस बोर्ड वॉट हैपन्स हियर मसल्स विल बी फॉर्म. द फोर्स इन दट मसल्स दे आर कॉल्ड व्हाट वी कॉल मस्क्युलर फोर्सेस. फ्रिक्शन इट इज द वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन दिस फोर्सेस एस्पेशली इन कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्सेस. फ्रिक्शन विच इज कॉल्ड एज फ्रिक्शन द फोर्स विच इज ऑपोजेस द फोर्स विच इज रेसिस्ट द मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज कॉल्ड एज व्हाट वी कॉल फ्रिक्शन फोर्स. सी फॉर एग्जाम्पल इट इज ए सरफेस. It is an object. It is tries to move on the surface. When it is tries to move on the surface, or palm of my hand, it resist the oppose the motion of this object. If we are tries to walk on the surface of the floor, when we try to walk on this floor, what happens? Floor resists the motion of this body. It opposes the walk on the floor. So the force which is opposed or resists the motion of the body, that is called what we call friction. Types of friction. There are three types of frictions are there. Before going to discuss about that classification, you have to remember two things here. Friction force. First one is frictional force. It is completely depends on the nature of the contact surface. Most important, nature of the contact surfaces only. Nature of the contact surface means what is its nature? It is rough or uneven. Rough or uneven or plain or even surface, it depends on the friction, depends on the nature of the contact surface. Then second one is most important one. Friction does not depend on the area of the body. It does not depends on the area of the body. It only depends on the nature of the contact surface. Then, what is that classification? So, here, forces are classification of forces. In this, first one is contact surfaces, contact forces. In this, one is normal force, second one tension, third one muscular force, fourth one is friction force. We are discussing about this one. Next, another one is, before going to discuss complete discussion on this friction, also going to just basic information on this gravitational force. What is that gravitational force? The force in between the two objects in the universe is called what we call gravitational force. For example, moon revolving around the earth, earth revolving around the sun. In this, which type of force acting? Gravitational forces. Then second one is electrostatic force. We know in electricity, when we have to hear this word electrostatic force, in these two types of charges are there. One is positive charge and another one is negative charge. These are the unlike charges. In between the either unlike charges or like charges, some forces are acting. Yes, these kind of forces are called what we call electrostatic force. In particular sense, Here, acting forces are called what we call attraction forces. But in between the like charges, which type of force acting? Repulsion forces acting between the like charges. Attraction forces acting in between the unlike charges. Unlike means one is positive and another one must be negative. Like means one is positive, another one also positive. One is negative, another one also negative. These kind of forces are called what we call repulsion forces. Which of the following type of forces acting in between the unlike charges? Attraction. Option B, repulsion. Option C, both. Option D, can't say. Yes, it is very simple, very basic concept, that is basic knowledge questions. Basic knowledge, understanding, application and numericals. These four categories are there in these to understand the subject. Yes, maybe examiner asking, first one is very basic knowledge, that is the basic knowledge question. Yes. What is the classification of the frictional forces? Friction force classified into just only discussed, that is three types. They are, one is static friction. Static friction. It is denoted by Fs. Static friction. See, for example, previous example, it is a book on the table. What is the state of this textbook? Yes, the state of the book is rest. When an object is rest position on the another object, on the another surface, in between these two surfaces, acting forces are called what we call static friction force. If two objects are at rest position, in between the two objects, acting forces are called what we call static friction force. Yes, it is denoted by Fs. Oftenly, we are using two words in physics. One is rest and another one is motion. Which is called rest position, which is called motion? Rest means the position of an object does not change with respect to place and time, that is called what we call rest. Position of an object does not change with respect to position, place, position or place and time, then the object is said to be in rest position. Motion, the state of an object will be varies with respect to place and time. Simply to say, object is change with respect to place or position and time period, then the object is in motion state. If an object is does not change with respect to place and time, that is called what we call rest position. However, here acting forces in between these two surfaces is static friction. It is denoted by Fs. See, if we try to move this object, but object does not get into the motion, isn't it? Some forces acting opposite direction to the external force are applied force. Yes. If we apply some forces on this material or book, maximum it tries to oppose or resist the motion of this object. It reaches the maximum force or maximum static friction or opposing force, that is called as limiting friction, which is called previous examination bit. Which of the following is called as limiting friction? Maximum static friction, maximum kinetic friction, maximum rolling friction, option D, all of the above. Maximum static friction is called as what we call limiting friction. It is denoted by FL. मैक्सिमम स्टैटिक फ्रिक्शन इज कॉल्ड एज लिमिटिंग फ्रिक्शन. व्हेन इट इज एक्सीड्स, व्हाट इज दैट फोर्स? लिमिटिंग फ्रिक्शन एक्सीडेड. देन व्हेन इट इज एक्सीड दैट लिमिटिंग फ्रिक्शन, देन ऑब्जेक्ट विल गेट इन टू द मोशन. दैट रिक्वायर्ड फोर्स टू ओवरकम दिस लिमिटिंग फ्रिक्शन, देन ऑब्जेक्ट विल गेट इन टू द आइदर मोशन स्टेट और रोलिंग स्टेट, और इट विल बी चेंज इट्स स्टेट. मीन्स मोशन स्टेट आर वॉट वी कॉल रोलिंग पोजिशन, इट विल बी इन रोलिंग पोजिशन. देन सेकेंड वन इज, सेकेंड कैटेगरी इज काइनेटिक फ्रिक्शन. काइनेटिक फ्रिक्शन और डायनेमिक फ्रिक्शन और रोलिंग फ्रिक्शन, सॉरी स्लाइडिंग फ्रिक्शन, स्लाइडिंग फ्रिक्शन इन जनरल इट इज डिनोटेड बाई एफ के, काइनेटिक फ्रिक्शन. काइनेटिक फ्रिक्शन और डायनेमिक फ्रिक्शन और स्लाइडिंग फ्रिक्शन. सी फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ए बॉय वॉकिंग ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द रोड, इन बिटवीन द फूट एंड दट रोड एक्टिंग फोर्स आर कॉल्ड व्हाट वी कॉल काइनेटिक फ्रिक्शन फोर्सेस आर डायनेमिक फ्रिक्शन फोर्सेस. Without frictional force, it is impossible to move on the surface. Then, next one is sliding friction. A, B, C are the three corners of this surface. AC, it is the inclined surface. Object is moving on this AC plane. How it is moving? Yes, due to the sliding friction. Then object is moving on an inclined surface. In that situation, acting forces between the two surfaces is called what we call sliding friction. Yes. Then third one is rolling friction. Very simple. When object is rolling, when it is rolls on the another surface, in that situation acting force are called what we call rolling friction. The best example we know very well. Yes, frictional forces in between the vehicle tires and road. Which of the following type of forces acting in between the vehicle tires and road? Static frictional forces, kinetic friction forces, rolling frictional forces, all of the above. See, object is not moves, roll. That is why when it is rolling on the surface, in this situation acting force are called what we call rolling frictional forces. How many forces are there? There are three types of force are there. One is static friction, kinetic friction, and another one is rolling friction. There are three types of frictions are there. Here the most important question, which of the following statement is correct one? Please try to understand which of the following statement is correct one. It is the understanding question. Option A, Fs is greater than Fk is less than Fr. Option B, Fs less than Fk greater than Fr. Option C, Fs less than Fk less than Fr. Option D, Fs greater than Fk greater than Fr. Important one. Fs greater than Fk greater than Fr. Yes. The question is which of the following statement or which of the following is correct one. For example, first one, Fs is greater than Fk, given options number one, Fs greater than Fk. means static friction, it is greater than the friction force. Is it correct or not? Let us see. In kinetic friction, object is easily moving. Object is moving. Our example is a boy walking on the surface of the road. Or it is here. It is in motion state. Why it is moving? Because of frictional force is less with comparatively static friction. In static friction, object is at completely rest position. It is rest. Why? Because here frictional force is more force acting on that material or object, that is why at rest. When it is overcome this force, what happens? It get into the motion. That is why Fs is greater than Fk. Okay, up to here this one is correct one. Yes, but see, in second case, second condition in the option A, Fk less than Fr given. One object is moving, another object is rolling. Which one contains less friction? When object is in rotating, in this case frictional force is less than comparatively kinetic friction. That is why this condition is wrong. So when it is wrong, this one is obviously wrong. Then second one, Fs less than Fk. Already we know Fs greater than Fk. So it is, this condition is wrong. That is why option B also wrong. Option C obviously wrong, because Fs less than Fk and Fk less than Fr in first condition also we know. So obviously Fs greater than Fk greater than Fr. How to reduce the friction? Reducing methods of friction. First method, by polishing. When the contact surfaces are polishing properly, frictional forces decreases. When friction decreases, obviously object will be easily moving on the surface of surfaces. Here there are two conditions are there. Condition number one, if contact surfaces are moderately polishing, if they are polishing moderately, properly polishing, what happens? Yes, obviously we know frictional forces decreases. When friction decreases, object is freely moving. Then second one, this is the important case, important one, repeated question in competitive examinations. If contact surfaces are heavily polished or too much or over polished, what happens the frictional forces? If contact surfaces are heavily polished or over polished, what happens? When they are, most important one, when they are polishing, heavily polishing or over polished, what happens here? Yes, when they are over polishing, it is an object, we know. This is the another object surface. When they are over polishing, what happens? These molecules called as contact molecules. Contact molecules are overlapping with each other like this. When they are overlapped with each other, intermolecules or contact molecules are overlapping with each other, then the effective frictional force, what happens? Increases. Most important one. Contact surfaces are over polished or heavily polished. What happened the frictional forces? The frictional forces increases, most important, increases. What happens here? Increase. Frictional forces increased, isn't it? Then, second one is very common method by using lubricants. And third one is by using ball bearings. Then fourth one is streamlining arrangement of the objects. Yes. See, by using lubricants, we know lubricants, which are used as lubricants to reduce the friction, oils, grease, and graphite. Oil, grease, and graphite. In very common uses, oil and grease, these are very commonly used in our daily life, in vehicles, automobiles, fan, like this. Electric motors also. And bicycles. Graphite, where it is using, most important one, this is graphite. Graphite, it is used in heavy vehicles. Which of the following used as a lubricant in heavy vehicles or in heavy motors? Which of the following is used as a lubricant in heavy machineries or heavy vehicles? Oil, grease, and graphite. Graphite is used as a lubricant in heavy machineries. What is that graphite? Graphite, it has the soft nature. What is the reason? Soft nature. It is, graphite, it is a allotrope of carbon. We know carbon is called as king of the elements. Which of the following is important one? Which of the following is called as king of the elements? Carbon. King of the chemicals? Sulfuric acid. Which of the following is called as king of the elements? Carbon. Which of the following is called as king of the chemicals? Sulfuric acid. Come to the point. So, graphite is the allotrope of carbon. Then we know ball bearings and streamline. What is the streamlining arrangement? See, for example, aeroplane is there. Aeroplane, it is, its wings stretch like this. When it is stretching, what happens? External forces, when it is moving, some external forces acting on the aeroplane. So, it is arranged in particular shape. That shape is helpful to penetrating in the air. So, wind forces acting on the aeroplane. Overcome from that forces, we must having some particular shape. See, for example, a bird flying in the sky, it has a one particular shape. Due to the having that kind of particular shape, it is easily fly. And when we are swimming in the water, we are not swim like this, just we have to stretch our hands and legs also. When it is stretching, easily we can move in the water. How it is possible? Having a particular shape, that kind of particular arrangement of the shapes of the object is called what we call streamlining arrangement. It is helpful to reduce the friction. See, one is particular arrangement of the are particular shapes of the objects. And also here one more important word is graphite is used as a lubricant in heavy machineries. It is the allotrope of carbon. Why it is used as a lubricant in heavy machineries? Reason for that one is it has the soft nature. Carbon, one more important word, it is the king of the element also. Next one is, if contact surfaces are heavily polished, what happens? Frictional forces increases. The condition is, if the contact surfaces are heavily polished, what happens to the frictional force? Yes, what happens here? When they are polishing, heavily polished, what happens? Frictional forces increases. Why it is increases? Intermolecules, contact molecules are interlocking with each other. This is the reason.